everybody. My name is Mackenzie. I will be guiding us through a slow flow class today. So what we're going to do is we're going to start lying on our backs on our mat. Lie down, get comfortable, close your eyes. Extend your legs out long. Relax your arms down by your sides or place one hand on your belly, one hand on your heart. Start to focus on your breath. Taking a deep inhale through your nose, letting your belly fill up, your rib cage open, your chest expand. Exhale through your mouth, let it all go. Inhale through your nose, let your belly fill up, your rib cage open, your chest expand. And exhale through your mouth, let it all out. This is our Durga Pranayama breath, or a three-part breath. Continue to focus on this breath throughout class. If at any point you lose track of your breathing, just find a neutral zone and start to regain. Slowly begin to draw your knees into your chest and give them a big squeeze. Rock and roll side to side, front, back. Getting a little spinal massage in here and a little bit of movement. Draw your knees into your chest and take a deep inhale. Exhale, slowly begin to drop your knees to the right side of your mat, keeping your shoulder blades planted, just feeling the stretch in your lower back, the outside of your hip. Draw your knees back to center and take a deep inhale. Exhale, drop your knees over to the left side of your mat. Keep your shoulder blades planted. Draw your knees back into your chest. Rock and roll front and back until you pop yourself up to a seated position. And then plant your hands. Step your feet back into a tabletop pose. You really want to stack your shoulders over your wrists, your hips over your knees. You can get a little bit of movement in here. Inhale, cow pose, drop your belly, lift your gaze up towards the ceiling and draw your shoulder blades together. Exhale, cat, curl your back, tuck your chin into your chest and press yourself away from your mat. Inhale, cow, drop your belly. And exhale, cat, curl your back. Inhale, cow, drop your belly, lift your gaze. Exhale, cat, curl your back, tuck your chin into your chest and press yourself away from the mat. Last one, inhale, cow, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, cat, tuck your chin into your chest. Come back to center. Inhale, reach your right arm up towards the ceiling. Exhale, thread the needle, send your right arm underneath your left. Coming all the way onto your right shoulder. You can wrap your left arm behind your back for more of a shoulder stretch if you would like. Place your left hand down, inhale your right arm high. And place it back down. Inhale, send your left arm high. Exhale, thread the needle, send your left arm underneath your right. Come all the way onto your left shoulder, your left ear. Wrap your right arm behind your back for more of a shoulder stretch. Plant your right hand down, inhale your left arm high, and place it back down. Get any extra movement that you might want in here. If you want to do another round of cat-cow, go ahead and do so. If you want to make a little S formation with your back, go ahead and do that as well. Pedal out your feet into the top of the mat, get some of that blood flow into your legs. Come to stillness. Take a deep inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale, curl your toes, send your hips up and back, downward facing dog. As a reminder, add a little bit of distance in between your fingers. Ground your fingers down into the mat, alleviating some of the pressure on your wrists. might be your first down dog of the day, so go ahead and get a little bit of movement in here. You can bend your knees, crack your toes. You want this upside down V formation with your hips and your spine. Heels as drawn to the mat as you can get them. Gaze towards your knees or toward the back of the room. Inhale. Exhale. Your arms overhead, mountain pose. Breathe here. Look down. Make sure that you ground all four corners of your feet down into the mat. Lift up on your knees to straighten your legs. Engage your core. Relax your shoulder blades down your back. Inhale. Exhale. Ground your left foot down. Grab your left wrist and pull over to the right, feeling the stretch in your left side body. Inhale back to center. Exhale, ground your right foot down, pull your right wrist over to the left side, feeling the stretch in your right side body. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, goal post your arms, arch your back, look up towards the ceiling for a little baby back bend. Inhale, back to center. And exhale, fold all the way forward. Inhale, halfway lift, draw your hands to your shins or your thighs. Exhale, drop your left hand down to the mat. And send your right arm high. If you need to have a little bend in your left knee, go ahead and do so. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, drop your right hand down, send your left arm high. If you need to add a little bend in your right knee, go ahead and do so. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back for a high plank pose. Shift forward slightly. Lower down all the way up to your mat, flipping to the tops of your feet. Press your chest up for a little baby cobra. Inhale. Exhale, lower back down. Press the tops of your feet into the mat so hard that your knees pop off. Ground your hands and lift your chest for upward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale, curl your toes, send your hips up and back. Downward facing dog. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway lift. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, reach your arms overhead, mountain pose. Exhale, ground your left foot down, send your arms over to the right. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, ground your right foot down, arms over to the left. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, baby back bend. Goal post your arms, look up towards the ceiling. Inhale, center. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, drop your left hand down, right arm goes high. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, right hand down, left arm goes high. Inhale, halfway. And exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back, high plank. Shift forward slightly. Lower down all the way onto your mat, or you can lower down halfway, keeping your elbows in tight. Flip to the tops of your feet and lift your chest, upward facing dog. Exhale, curl your toes, send your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Inhale, exhale, one more breath, inhale, and exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Last one, inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach your arms overhead, mountain pose. Exhale, arms over to the right. Feel the stretch in your left side body. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, arms over to the left, feeling the stretch in your right side body. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, baby back bend. Inhale, center. And exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, drop your left hand down, send your right arm high. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, drop your right hand down, left arm goes high. Inhale halfway. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back. Your option here to flow, hold high plank, or just send yourself straight to down dog. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath, inhale. And exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, chair pose. Bend your knees, sit low, send both arms overhead. Draw more weight into your heels. If you need to add a little bit of distance in between your feet to feel more stable, go ahead and do so. Engage your core. Relax your shoulder blades. Inhale. Exhale, open arm twist to the right. Send your right arm up behind you, keeping your left arm forward. Inhale, center. Exhale, open arm to the left. Inhale, center. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands and step your left foot back. Drop your left heel down. Look down, make sure that you have heel-to-heel alignment here. Right toes pointing towards the top of your mat. Left toes, left side of the room. Keep a bend in your right knee and lift your chest. Warrior One stance. You might need to square your hips to the front of the room, so go ahead and press this right hip back to do so. Arms overhead. Inhale. Exhale, readjust Warrior Two. Open your chest to the left side of the room. Send both arms out to a T. Look over your right hand. Inhale. Exhale, extended side angle. Reach forward with your right. Place it all the way down to the mat or resting it on your right thigh. Left arm goes high. Gaze up towards the ceiling or down at your mat. Inhale, reverse. Left arm down, right arm goes high. Keep this bend in your right knee. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands. Step your left foot to meet your right. Forward fold at the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands. Step your right foot back. Look down, make sure that you have heel-to-heel alignment. Left toes pointing towards the top of the mat. Right toes, right side of the room. Keep a bend in your left knee. Lift your chest, Warrior One stance. Again, you might need to square your hips, so press your left hip back to do so. Inhale. Exhale, readjust. Open your chest to the right side of the room. Arms go out to a T, Warrior Two stance. Looking over your left hand, inhale. Exhale, extended side angle. Reach forward with your left. Send it down, right arm goes high. Inhale, reverse. Right arm down, left arm high. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands. Step back, high plank. And send yourself straight to down dog. Take this time to come back to your breath. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair pose. Bend your knees, sit low. Exhale, open arm twist to the right. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, open arm to the left. Inhale, back to center. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step your left foot back. Look down, make sure they have heel to heel alignment, and then lift your chest, Warrior One. Inhale. Exhale, readjust, Warrior Two stance. Inhale, look over your right hand. Exhale, extended side angle. Send your left arm high. Reach energetically with this left hand. Inhale, reverse. Left arm down, right arm high. Feel the stretch in your right side body. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands. Step your left foot to meet your right. Forward fold. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Plant your hands. Step your right foot back. Inhale, lift your chest, Warrior One. Exhale, readjust, Warrior Two. Inhale, look over your left hand. Exhale. Exhale, extended side angle. Reach forward with your left, send it down, right arm goes high. Inhale, reverse, right arm down, left arm high. Feel the stretch in your left side body. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back, high plank, and send yourself straight to down dog. Pedal out your feet, get a little bit of movement in here. Roll out your ankles if you need. Come back to your breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway. And fold. Last time, inhale, chair pose. Bend your knees, sit low. Exhale, open arm, twist to the right. Inhale, center. Exhale, open arm to the left. Inhale, center. And exhale, fold forward. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, plant your hands, step your left foot back. Inhale, lift your chest, warrior one. Exhale, readjust, warrior two. Inhale, look over your right hand. Exhale, extend, reach forward with your right, send it down, left arm goes high. Inhale, reverse, left arm down, right arm high. Exhale, forward fold, plant your hands, step your left foot to meet your right. Last side, inhale, half lift. Exhale, fold, plant your hands, step back. Inhale, lift your chest, warrior one. Exhale, readjust, warrior two. Inhale. Exhale, extend, reach forward. Left arm down, right arm goes high. Inhale, reverse. Right arm down, left arm goes high. Exhale, fold, plant your hands. Step back, high plank. Send yourself straight to down dog. Get some movement, pedal out your feet. Come back to your breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale, look forward. Exhale, step or hop to the top. Slowly begin to roll up one vertebra at a time. Stand up nice and tall. Roll out your shoulders. Send your shoulders up to kiss your ears and then back down. Close your eyes. Draw your hands to heart center for Samasthiti. And come back to your breath. Open your eyes. Take this time to grab a block or something that you can use as a balancing tool. Place your block in front of your mat. Slowly begin to rise up. Draw your hands to heart center. Add a little bend into your left knee and step your left foot back. Look down. You kind of want to have heel-to-heel alignment here. Right toes pointing towards the top of your mat. Left toes pointing towards left side of the room or the top left corner of your mat, whatever feels better. Knees are straight here and chest is square to the front of the room. Send both arms overhead. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, fold forward, pyramid pose. Draw your hands down to the block or draw your hands down to frame your foot. Whatever feels better. We really want to feel the stretch in the back of our right thigh, our hips. Take a couple deep inhales and deep exhales here. Grab your block and place your block on the inside of your right foot. And plant your hand all the way onto the top of the block. Slowly begin to send your right arm high, coming into revolve triangle pose. You want to keep your knees as straight as possible here. If you need to have a little microbend, obviously feel free to do that. Do what feels best for your body. And reach up towards the ceiling with that right hand. Send your gaze up towards the ceiling or down to your mat, whatever is easiest on your neck. Slowly begin to send that right hand down to frame your foot. You can keep using the block or you can place the block in front of you and ground both hands down to the mat. Slowly begin to add your weight into your right foot and add a little bit of a bend into your right knee. Start to add this weight back into your right foot, and as you do, you're going to kick your left leg off, coming into a standing split. You have the option here to come into a half moon. You can grab your block and place your right hand on the block or keep your right hand on the mat and start to send your left arm high. Open your chest, the left side of the room. Hold for three. Forward fold in two. One, forward fold. Plant your right, left hand down to meet your right. Left foot down to meet your right. Pedal out your feet, getting a little bit of blood flow back in. Place that block back into the front of your mat and slowly begin to rise up. Roll out your shoulders. Add a little bend into your right foot and step your right foot back. Again, you can look down for heel-to-heel alignment. Your left toes are gonna be towards the front of the room, right toes, right side of the room, or top right corner, whatever feels better for your body and your hips. Square your hips to the front of the room and send both arms overhead. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, fold your chest forward, pyramid pose. Hands down to frame your left foot or to the block, whatever feels better. Take a couple deep inhales and deep exhales here. Keep your right hand down to the block or all the way onto the mat. And start to send your left arm high, coming into a revolved triangle pose. Again, if you need to have a little microbend, go ahead and do so, but we really want to keep this left knee as straight as possible. Send your gaze up towards the ceiling or down to your mat, whatever feels better for your neck. Down to frame your left foot. Add your weight into your left foot, and as you do, you're going to kick that right leg off, coming into a standing split. You can stay right here if you would like to move a little bit deeper. Ground your left hand down to the block or to the mat, and start to send your right arm high, coming into half moon. Open your chest to the right side of the room. Hold for three. Forward fold in two. One forward fold. Step your right foot to meet your left. Pedal out your feet, get a little bit of blood flow back in. Slowly begin to roll up one vertebra at a time. Roll out your shoulders. Pedal out your feet. Roll out your ankles if that feels good. And then find stillness. Draw your hands to heart center. Draw your weight into your left foot and add a little bit of bend into your right knee. Open your right knee to the side of the room. You have a couple options here. You can place your foot on your ankle and use it kind of as a kickstand. You can place your foot at your shin, or you can draw your foot all the way up to your inner thigh. But we really want to avoid our knee here. Coming into tree pose. You can have a couple different options with your arms. You can keep your hands at heart center, arms overhead, behind your back if that feels good. Find a non-moving object to focus on. add your weight into your right foot. Add a little bit of a bend into your left knee and open your left hip to the side of the room. Place your foot at your ankle, your shin, or assist it all the way up to your thigh, but avoiding your knee. We really want to have everything even on this side, so if you place it at your shin, place it at your shin again. If you drew it up to your thigh, bring it up to your thigh. And again, same thing with your hands. You place them at heart center, overhead, or behind your back. And just focus on a non-moving object. Follow, just come back in. Hold for three. Draw your knee back to center in two. One, draw back to center, place it down, pedal it out. One more, we're gonna come into dancer's pose. So what we're gonna do is send both arms overhead. And slowly you're gonna release your right arm down by your side, palm facing up. If you have a strap, you can also use your strap while doing this. You're gonna add your weight into your left leg and bend your right knee. Grab the inside of your right foot. Coming into dancer's pose. This is dancer's pose, you can stay right where you are. If you would like to move a little bit forward, pressing your chest forward and kicking your foot to your hand, go ahead and do so, but you don't have to. Begin to roll back onto your belly. Getting a little bit of movement, you can send your arms out in front of you, kind of counteract this stretch. Bend your knees, roll your ankles. And send your arms out to a T, palms facing down. Slowly begin to roll onto your left shoulder blade. And draw your right knee into your chest, or place the sole of your right foot on the mat behind. Bring your head all the way down to the ground or to the mat. And take a couple breaths. Thank you. Again, getting some movement, sending your arms out in front of you. Roll out your wrists, bend your knees. Bring your hands by your ribs. And slowly begin to place your forearms and your palms down to the mat. Elbows about shoulder width distance apart. Place the tops of your feet into the mat and just slowly begin to lift your chest. Send your gaze out in front of you. You're about 6 inches in front of your mat. Coming into Sphinx pose. Really just stretch out this lower back and our shoulders. Take a couple deep inhales and deep exhales. Begin to rise into your tabletop pose and come through and have a seat on your mat. Extending your legs out long in front of you. Flex your toes towards your face and reach your arms overhead. Inhale. Exhale, seated forward fold, grabbing at your toes, your ankles, your shins, whatever is accessible while keeping your knees as straight as possible. Your inhale will lengthen your spine, and your exhales are going to help your chest draw a little bit deeper towards your thighs. Let it happen. closing, to draw your right knee into your chest and send your left knee up to meet it. Extend your right leg out long. Release your left arm down by your side. Using your right hand, slowly begin to guide your left knee over your body. Again, keeping your shoulder blades planted. Letting your exhales naturally draw your knee towards the mat. Draw your left knee into your chest. Send your right knee up to meet it. Grab the insides of your feet and send your feet up towards the ceiling for happy baby pose. Rock and roll side to side, getting some spinal massage, opening your hips. You can bend one knee, straighten the other. Bend both knees, do what feels good. Take this time to get in any extra movement that we might have missed or something that you really like to do. Maybe there's a stretch that you really love. And then when you are ready, slowly begin to draw your knees into your chest. Give them a big squeeze and take a deep inhale through your nose, letting your belly fill up, your rib cage open. Exhale through your mouth for your final shavasana. Extend your legs out long. Release your arms down by your sides. Close your eyes. Relax your tongue away from the roof of your mouth. And completely settle into your mat for these next couple minutes. Feel free to stay in Shavasana for a little bit longer if you'd like. Or if you'd like to be guided out, start adding some movement to your toes and your fingers. Send your arms overhead for a full body stretch. And slowly begin to roll onto your right or left side body. Resting your head on your bicep or your forearm and drawing your knees into your chest. Yourself up to a seated position. Cross your legs and draw your hands to heart center. Close your eyes if they're not already. Drop your chin down to your chest. want to, which means may all beings everywhere be happy and free, and may the thoughts, words, and actions in my own life contribute in some way to the happiness and freedom of others. Draw your hands to third eye center, the place between your eyebrows, and bow together. Namaste. Thank you, everybody, for coming.